You have selected a help video for these columns within the matrix, D, E, F, and G. G is price, F is group, and E is ticker, and D is the name column. The name column is the most complicated one. We're going to talk about that in detail. The group's just agricultural bonds, energy, forex, grains, industrial metals, precious metals, and stocks. The price of the assets, and this is the call tickers for the assets over here. There's more assets located or listed in the matrix. They're just blocked out so we can focus on this particular video on these markets for clearer understanding. The name column is what everyone focuses on. It's the asset's name here, the composite trend, the cycle, whether it's early, mid, or late, the T, which is the time of days, and it's in days, so it's 50 days, and the mean minus T. So this is how far this 50 days is passed or above the below or above the normal cycle. It's minus, it's beyond the normal cycle. So this one's 50 days past the normal duration for an impulse in corn. This one, or soybeans, is at 133 days, is 119 days past the normal cycle. Soybeans is quite extended. We've talked about that before. This number right here scores the definitions. We want to put this in terms of like our metrics for the impulse, and then this scores the cycle terms in terms of a Z score, which is really between zero, which is the mean, and anything that goes on to up to 5, 6, 7 standard deviations. The whole point of this number right here is to compare not only assets within the same group but outside the other groups. We're looking for the numbers that are the lowest. Let's assume that all these markets reset. We'd be looking for the market that we'd be most interested in would have the lowest cycle composite score. Cycle composite score is located in the composite trend alignment. You can see the designations here. They're based off of this number right here, and that's a function of the price and time cycles. So if we were choosing between this limited matrix universe, if any of them reset, Bitcoin would receive first priority, followed by wheat. If you're restricted to grain trading only, a reset would be focusing on the wheat market because it has the lowest cycle score. The reason why these cycles are high and shaded red right here, and the computer designates them as late, is because of the time and cycle scores across the multiple time frames. The daily is pretty extended. We can see these for corn and soybeans. The time cycles, which is a measure of the normal duration of the impulse on the daily, is well above 2. This is an extremely extended setup. And even on the weekly, they're extended here and extended here. Wheat is extended on a price time, but relatively speaking, when we compare all of the cycles across the board simultaneously, it scores them relative to these numbers, and the lowest number is the most attractive. Doesn't mean the lowest number is always going to produce the best return. It just means if you want to commit money above and beyond the core position. Remember, core positions are always bought when the primary trends flip, and these primary trends have flipped 4, 6, and 6 months ago. So these things have been long positions for quite some time. If there was a reset and you wanted to participate or escalate the position, you would be looking for the markets with the lowest number, would be the most attractive. Personally, I tend not to focus on anything that's to above and early. Why commit any money and sometimes I dabble in a mid, and I definitely don't touch anything that's a late cycle. So that's the setup within the column, the name column, the ticker column, the group column, and the price column. Or it's not really the setup, it's the description of how we use them. The last thing that I wouldn't want to leave out is sigma. Sigma is volatility. Volatility is based off of these particular measures, and I don't want to go into too much detail because the computer will tell us what's going on. When you see this high arrow, up arrow, and EXP, that's expansion, that's a market that's accelerating to the upside. It's overextended to some, it's in some ways of looking at it, it's you're suggesting that the market's overbought. That's one way of looking at it, but it's not as simple as saying it's overbought in the daily. It's overbought relative to all three time frames. A market that's in expansion has been accelerating. It's difficult if you're looking at the matrix on a day-to-day basis and you're have an inkling to chase corn or wheat, you tend not to want to chase it to the upside when you're under expansion. The opposite of that is compression. It will be marked by a down arrow and signified by three words, COM, which is compression or downside compression or high compression. That's similar to having a market that's highly compressed with very low volatility. It's a sign that a market's ready to enter acceleration and move into expansion. Markets oscillate between compression and expansion. You just don't see it. Its volatility is difficult to measure or even visualize by your eye. It's actually the whole concept of it is relative to the signal to noise ratio in whether it be frequencies or radio or electromagnetics. A market that's in expansion is highly focused to the upside and is highly directional. Compression market has no direction whatsoever, but it's ready to move into expansion. If you can find a market that's in compression and it moves to expansion in terms that usually follows the primary trend here, it's usually a good profit opportunity and it's a good to get into those markets. So it watched the sigma number in terms of the overall trend, and it is the composite trend it's measuring. It's all three trends at the same time, and they are measured right here. So that's really the description of the name, ticker, and group and price columns. If you have any other questions, contact me directly through the blog or make some comments below. I can respond back to that. But this should help you use these three columns better to execute off of the evolution of the trade better. You need to understand the evolution of the trade, but in order to do that, you have to understand these four columns better. So thanks for watching the video and read some more help files.